Some of the things that we changed in our program, we are expanding the focus on cultural and linguistic competency. For example, everything that we teach, that we do in all programmatic activities have to incorporate context related to cultural competency, health equity, looking at provider bias, language access, that are some of the key areas in training and building, no, the future workforce that is going to be working with communities that are affected by autism or other developmental disabilities. We have also expanded the faculty that provide training in our programs. We know that one of the most effective ways to address disparities is to diversify the workforce. So we partner with other programs around the country, especially faculty who are working with Native American communities. So we have two Navajo speech language pathologies that are part of our program, specifically looking at historical trauma and cultural perspectives of disability in those communities, which is very different from other areas that we have been focusing on. So I think it's being creative about how we diversify the workforce, how we diversify, for example, the trainee pool that we take every year in our program. Our program, even though we are in the second whitest state in the country, we have 50% to 70% racial diversity in trainees. And one of the most important changes that we have made is ensuring that all parents have access to education and leadership training. Not historically, it has been very specific groups of parents that have access to LEND programs. So we make sure that immigrant parents and refugee and other historically underrepresented groups are also part of our program. No? So it's community education, provider education, and also being strategic about how we diversify the workforce and our programs to meet specific needs of communities.